Hey guys, I'm back. I did this Get Ready With Me. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Enjoy it. I'll see you in a few minutes. Bye. So the first step I'm going to be taking is washing my hands, which I already did that, and I'm using the Bath & Body Works sanitizer and Pink Diamond. It's really good. It's strong, but it's good. It has glitter, specks of glitter. I don't like that, but it's really good. And then the moisturizer I just put on my face is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizer Gel. This is a really good gel. I like it for my oily skin when I want to have more of a matte look. It's a really good product, and people that have, you know, oily skin, I just totally forgot what I was saying. People that have oily skin, I recommend this. It's not the best, like, high-end moisturizer, but it is a really good moisturizer to have in your collection. And I believe they have one for dry skin. Don't know exactly, but that's what I heard. That's why I bought that. I'm gonna get a drink real quick. Okay, so anyways, I'm gonna start off with my eyes today because I'm using pigment and glitter and everything else on my eyes today, so I don't want to start with my foundation, because when you do your eyes with pigments and glitter, it falls on your face. And so everybody knows that when you do that and you already put foundation on, it's really hard to get off and just work with after. So a lot of times people put their eyeshadow on before. I was thinking about something, sorry. My husband and daughter went on a daddy-daughter date type of thing, so I'm just kind of home alone, you know, because yesterday when I recorded this, it was a really bad video. I'm just like, nope, not happening. Like, it was blurry. I'm like, I can't do that. So, yes. And let's see what I was gonna say. Anyways, sometimes people like to put tape outwards so like you have more of a precise look, but I don't think I'm doing that today just because, well, actually let's do it just so people know what I'm talking about. So I don't really work a lot with tape with my eyes just because if I do put makeup on, I'm just kind of scrambling nowadays, and just like, I'm just actually making time for you guys because I want to. Because I love talking to you guys and wanting to do a Get Ready With Me. So what you want to do is you try to do like, I'm going to move this really close up to me so I can actually see what I'm doing. Let's see. Okay. So what you want to do is kind of like, I'll show you, right? You guys want to have an even look. I don't know if that's right, but we're gonna try this. See that right in there? You just want to press down, pat it. You don't want to like swipe it because you don't want to move. It's really, you know, it's just really bad if you do that. I'm just thinking how this look's gonna turn out, because when I did this yesterday, I wasn't like, it was just weird looking, I don't know. And I didn't really use I think that's more down. Okay, so we're gonna actually try this. See how it's like right there? So when I do my eyeliner and my eyes, nothing will go past that line. Sorry, I'm just kind of like patting it in. Anyways, let's do primer. So everybody knows, most everybody knows, when you do your eyes, you want to have an eye primer when you want to have your eyeshadow last. Drugstores have been coming out with some really good products lately. And they came out, Milani came out with a really good eye primer, but since I'm doing like a high-end today, I'm going to do my MAC Paint Pod in Pain Curly. It's a really good paint pod. Like, I adore this. Like, it's probably my go-to eye primer besides like my MAC Prolongwear concealer. I love to use that as well, but my paint pod is like my go-to. Like, when they say that the, is it Maybelline Locket? Which one is the Maybelline one they use? The tattoo one? They're like, oh, it's like the same, but to me it's not the same. Like, they're so different in a lot of ways. So, I like to get up high. So, you really want to like pat it too, because you don't want to swipe. If it swipes up, you don't want to rub, because your eyes are so like, they don't need to be worn down more than what they have to, because you don't want aging on them. So like, keep in mind that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get actually my Morphe 350 palette. It's one of the shades I'm going to be working with. These are the colors. If you can tell, they're really, really cute and adorable. So I'm actually going to start working. And a lot of times with eye primers, you really want to make sure it's not tacky, because a lot of times when you do that, sorry, I got the wrong shade. Snap. When you get the wrong shade, that could be bad. When you don't let it dry completely and you have it tacky, a lot of times eyeshadows get uneven and stuff like that. So what I'm doing is I'm going to be taking this shade in the second row right here, and I'm going to be like putting that on my crease. I'm kind of just working it on my eyelid too as well, just kind of making sure that it's kind of not tacky anymore and just all dried, because you don't want that to happen. But I'm going to be working it more in the crease. Putting eyeshadow in the crease and bringing it upwards makes your eyes look a lot bigger, and that's why I do it, especially when I have hooded eyes. But it's really, makeup has came a long way since I started. So that's a really good thing. So if you can see my face, you really want to get in there. You really want to blend too. Because the more you blend, the more even it's going to look as well. You just want a flawless application. If you guys can tell. So after I pull off the tape, this, nothing should go past that line. So we're going to see how well I did and how well I got. But the pigment's always going to transfer. I look like a hot tomato. Like, my face is on fire, it looks like. Which it is, because that's how my face is. But it just looks really bad on camera, how red it is. I don't know, does it look really bad, you guys? Okay, so let's blend this in. And then the next shade I'm actually going to do is right like a shade over, well, two shades over, and I'm gonna use this looker eyeshadow right here. Da, 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 da. You guys have any plans for the holidays? We're going to hopefully see family and on Nick's side, my husband's side, and then my side, hopefully. We can get together during Christmas because I love Christmas. It's like my favorite time of the year besides like fall. So pretty. Especially when you get to have fun with family that you never get to see and make stuff that you never get to do. Just a really good time. And I know there's stress involved with everything that comes with, you know, family and season and stuff, but just make the best of it. That's what you can only do around this time. Enjoy what you do have instead of what you don't have, because a lot of people forget what they do have instead of what they don't have. So I am loving everything that I've gotten. So if you guys can tell, it seems really dark, but I'm trying to like blend it in my crease and kind of go upwards. You never want to go down because it brings your eyes like downwards, and we're trying to like bring lift the eyes up. So what I'm gonna do is I actually got this brush in a set on Amazon, and I think you use it under with your concealer setting it, but does my face look really dark? I don't know. I'm trying to like help you guys see my face a lot better, but it's not really working. Okay, so I got this brush on an Amazon little kit thing, and usually you put it under your eyes with your setting, but I actually use it with like blending out, and it actually works really, really good. So I'm actually really excited because I kind of got a few things for my Christmas gift that I actually do every year for me. I just kind of like have that time and get a few things that I really want that I don't actually splurge on during the year, because we actually just had a baby, so I don't have a lot of time to do me now. I'm just more like with Harper a lot and just kind of, you know, just how it goes. And I love every second of it. Okay, so I think that's really blended out. I don't know if that looks like on camera, but we'll see how this turns out. It's really looking good on my end. So what I'm gonna do is actually take a little bit darker shade. And I'm actually gonna, well, let's actually go with more of an orangey look right now, because I'm going to do this one and probably this one or that one. Just kind of, let me see. I'm actually going to do this one right here. It's more of a red brown brick color, and it's really pretty. I love this color. I don't know why I just put that on my blending brush, but we'll kind of work it in and then do it on the other side quick. But anyways, I've been, you know, I just got a few things. I got a few palettes again that I needed, like, it wasn't like, I kind of like really researched and like knew what I was getting before I bought it, just because we do live a far away from the nearest like Sephora. So I'm like, if I'm going to get it, I'm going to actually know what I'm getting, you know. So, but anyways, I got a few palettes and I'm actually going to get them tomorrow. They're supposed to be coming, and then I'll do that video for you guys to show you what I got. I didn't get a lot, but like I got like more than what I was going to. So And you just want to like really work in your shades and blend them really good. I'm going to take that Sigma E35, and it's just a tapered blending brush. And I'm going to just blend it, try to blend it. Get it in there, right in here. But life has been crazy for us. Like, a lot of things have been changing lately, and so I don't get a lot of time to actually, let's see, you know, do videos right now, but I'm wanting so bad just to, you know, connect with you guys, because I feel like you guys are family and you guys know me, a lot of you. So it helps me just to know that I'm helping you guys out. So since the eyeshadow is getting darker, I really want to like not bring them in so far. So I'm going to try to keep them from like more of the outwards now, since I'm actually going to get into darker shades now. If you guys can see that. It's actually coming off really dark on camera. I don't know why, but I'm actually going to like figure out the lighting after I get done. Like, maybe probably tomorrow I'm going to like really look at it and see what I can do for you guys. Okay. So I'm going to like, I don't want to go all out because I know this is like extreme, like crazy, because a lot of times people don't have time like this, but this is like when you guys want to go and do something. This is just a get ready with me too, so it's not like you don't have to, like, I'm just showing you what I do when I get ready. But this is like not what I usually do, so it's kind of like first impressions too what I'm doing. Because I don't really use a lot of products like this a lot of times. Like I said, I kind of like throw it on lately. Okay, so my next one I'm going to be doing is I'm trying to like think which one I'm gonna do. I think yesterday I did this one, but it was really dark, so I'm gonna do this one instead. And that was on the bottom, if you guys can tell, the fourth one. Well, in the middle, so I'm gonna try that. And that looks more of a purplish brown to me, but who knows? Let's see. Because a lot of times I feel like when I put it on my eyes, they don't actually go on my eyes the color that is in the pan. So, let's try this out. And I want to keep it on the outwards just because I want to make my eyes look bigger. And I don't want them to look super heavy, but I know this is a very dark, warm color on my eyelids, but I mean eyes, I mean the crease. I'm like all over just because I have so much on my mind and so much stuff I want to tell you guys, but I can't right now, so I'm just like, ugh. So I'm gonna like go halfway over, I think. Just kind of work it in over there and just kind of like, and then I'm gonna bring it down a little bit. And these Morphe eyeshadows are actually really, really, like, nice, but they're not as nice as the Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I think that's just me. So, I really like my Makeup Geek cosmetics, so Marlena does a really good job. I love how she has turned the game of the makeup world. Like, I think ever since she came out with eyeshadows, like, the game has changed. Like, everybody has been picking up like the slack, you know, and trying to like beat, you know, like the makeup world is, everybody tries to get the best product out. But nothing beats Makeup Geek. Like, I think everybody tries to beat them, but not happening, woman. Okay. I'm actually going to, like, blend that stuff up. Blend that. So I'm going to, like, do the outwards, just kind of soften the outside. Because you don't want them harsh. And so I'm actually going to use a pigment from Makeup Geek that I bought it because I loved it. And then I forgot about it because it's not in my pan, you know, in a pan. So I'm just like, forget about it. Because I have it in my single eyeshadows because I have everything organized. And sometimes it gets forgotten. So if you guys like me rambling, tell me, because I feel like I'm going crazy right now with this get ready with me. But what can you do is just talk in a video for you guys, get to know you. Okay, so I'm gonna blend this more out. Each layer you put on, you still want to blend really good. I keep on touching my face because I just washed it. And it looks like I got some makeup underneath. And I don't know if I was blending it too much down in the crease and it just kind of fell in. But oh well. So I need to get going because this video is going to take forever. Okay, so anyways, let's get the pigment out because I think I'm going to go just with that, just because I'm going to go crazy if I keep on going. I'll probably have a black eyelid in the crease. Black look. Black look. So before I do anything on my eyelids, usually working with pigments, you want to use like a sticky tacky glue, but I don't have that because I can't find it. I have it, I just can't find it. And so I kind of have like a like color base, I would say, like a shade that kind of, you know, works with the pigment that I'm going to be using. And I'm going to be using the Makeup Geek in Vegas Lights. Very, very bronzy. Very just, oh my gosh, I'm gonna like try not to make it everything go everywhere, but look at that. Like, it's really dark, but it's like bronzy, if you can see that. It's so pretty. Works really good with blue eyes. So if you have blue eyes, get your hands on it. And then the kind of base I'm working with is the Il Maschera. Kind of like, I got this off of Holt Look, and it's kind of like the same color. But this is like a, it's actually in, it's a liquid metal. But I think this is for your face, body. Your face, you can do it on your cheeks, your lips, and your eyes. But I usually only do, my camera keeps on shutting off. I only use this on my eyes because I don't want this on my cheeks and my lips unless it's like summertime and it's like a really good party you're going to. But so I'm gonna put it on my eyelid. Now, if you don't have a lot of money, I'll do like a drugstore look too. But if you don't have a lot of money, like you're like to the ends, like you want a different color, but you need a different color, but you don't want to like spend a lot of money. Hard Candy has some really good metallic eyeshadows in those tubes. So, anyways, yeah. I don't know about you, but like whenever I put my eyes, like whenever I work my eyes, I like open my mouth, I'm just like, yeah. So, you always want to have makeup wipes around you. I use the e.l.f. makeup remover cleansing cloths. I like them a lot for only $3. Like, I think they work amazing. They come off, like, they remove, like, all of my good, like, heavy-duty makeup, and they're only $3, so, yeah. I think that's not sealed, so that's probably gonna get under. Great. So I'm kind of gonna clean that up. Anyways, if you look like this look, well, the eye look, just, you know, you don't have to go further, but if you want the pigment on as well, you know, keep on going. But if you don't want to do a lot of bronzy look, you don't have to take this next step. Well, which I need this. So, I'm actually going to use my Chit number 5 brush to pack it on. And with the pigment, I'm going to actually spray. I usually set it, like, spray on the setting spray on my brush. But I'm going to use a cheaper one just because everybody likes to go cheap sometimes. So I'm going to actually spray this over here. And I like to get a really good amount on there to get pack on with the eyeshadow. If I'm looking up there, I'm saying if my camera's gonna die anytime. So you wanna like pat it. You don't wanna get it all over. Just kinda dab it off, which every time you use, you should kinda flick it off so you don't have excess on there. And then you wanna pat it. If you guys can see that, it's really pretty, isn't it? Hopefully my camera's like really picking up this shade, because it is so pretty, especially like fall time. It's really pretty time. If you have a party to go to, like Halloween, and you want to like do some crazy looks, this is a really pretty. And like, I like the gold under it because the El Mosquas eyeshadow is like bringing out the gold too. So it's like bronzy and gold at the same time. So, really pretty, ladies and gents. So, usually I like to spray a lot more than what I probably should, but it keeps the pigment on more. If you guys know what I'm saying. And try not to like open your eyes, like let it, like once you get it on there, let it dry, like with your eyes down, closed, I mean. Because then you don't have creases, just because for me, I didn't put my tacky glue on, so it's just not gonna last forever. Like, it would last a lot longer if I put it on, but I can't find it, so. Anyways, I'm going to can you guys tell the difference? I don't know if you guys can, but it's really, really pretty. It's a hot mess right now, but I'm going to let it dry. Try to let it dry as much as possible. And once you dry, you never want to dry you never want to blend the outside until they're completely dry, the pigment, because if you want a muddy look, that's fine with you, but with me, I don't like to blend until my pigment's already dry. So, I'm getting some caffeine in me because I'm tired right now. And right now, since I'm going to put some, let's see, chapstick on, because I'm going to put matte lips on. If you guys can tell, all that pigment's on my face. That's why you don't want to apply foundation on your face until afterwards. So, I'm actually going to try. But anyways, I'm going to do this. It's a BH Cosmetics in number 5. I'm just going to blend it. Try to blend it out so it's not as harsh, which you guys should know. Like I said. Okay. So, it's not my most, I don't know. This glitter is not working right now. Like, I love the color, but it's like, it seems like it's going everywhere. Like, I give up. So anyways, I don't give up. I never give up. Anyways, I'm going to actually get a little bit brown and try to put it in my outward crease, just to get it in, get darker out there. That makes looks better. Anyways, let's hurry up because I'm sure you guys don't want to watch me all day. So I'm going to just kind of blend it out again. Okay, so I'm going to take the tape off and see how much it actually helped. Ready, you guys? Oh my gosh. You always want to go upwards too. Wait. Eyeliner. So, we'll see how this works. Yesterday I used this Kat Von D Locket eyeliner and I didn't really like it with the glitter, how it turned off, because it just wasn't as pigmented. And I had to like put 3 coats on. So, let's see if it's... This tape is crazy. Yeah, it's like... I'm going crazy. It goes black on my hand, it's just not going well. And with me, I have a hard time because I like to pull my eyelid back when I do eyeliner, and it's just like really hard for me to not do it. So eyeliner is not going to be on fleek like you guys like, but hey, I'm trying my best for you guys. And that is a total fail. So please do not follow this eyeliner trick right now. I will show you guys how I do it with not without pigment. So, who is that? I can't. My phone goes off and I'm like, who is that? So I'm going to try my, let's see, Revlon Color Last, I think, Color Stay. I really like this. I used to use this a lot back in the day. See how this goes on so much better? Oh my gosh. Yes. It's not like perfect, but you can actually see it. Okay, see what a difference? Probably can't see, but. Da-da-da-da-da. So, my eyeliner is really, really, let's be honest, it's not perfect at all. Like, it can go die right now. But, let's just get over with this eyeliner. Let's make it the best looking we can, as we can. So, I'm actually going to take my eye tape, my eyeshadow, the tape off. Oh my gosh, I'm just all over. Okay. See how much better that is? Like, dang, I might be doing this all over again. And like, always having tape. Like, look at that. Like, I need to wipe this stuff off, but always go upwards with your... I forgot how much pigment goes off. So you really want to like clean that up. And it's going to fall. Like, it's going to keep on falling if you don't have like a really good tacky. And especially since I like put on a lot. It's gonna come off really good. A lot more than what I wanted to. See how like perfect that is? Well, like the straight up. So if you want a really good line that you know, like more of a drama queen look, do this trick and you can be on fleek with it. Okay, so that is done. I am really thirsty. My eyes. So anyways, this is probably a really long video, but my camera is probably, I need to get going. So I really talk a lot and I ramble. Anyways, let's go with foundation. Foundation, we need primer before, because I'm a really, like, my primer has to go on before my foundation, always. Unless I'm running somewhere and I just throw on some powder, but usually I put on a primer as well. So, and today I'm going to be using the Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. It's really good. It's expensive, but oh my gosh, they say it's for oily skin, but I think it's for a lot of people with needs, you know, help with their skin. Because this makes your skin so smooth and just helps out. Like, every time I use it, I see a difference in my skin. So, I have glitter all over my face. I don't know if you can see that, but it's like... Oh my gosh. Cray cray. Anyways, I love this foundation. I really think a lot of people should go out and get it. Even just get this small size like this, it's really good. I'll try to find a link to it and show you guys how much it is. It's probably around the $20 or $30 range for that, but I wouldn't trade it for the world. It's really good. So my next product I'm going to be using is a foundation I can't find because I'm blind. Bum, 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 bum. Where is it? Like, oh my gosh. I might have to use a different foundation. I don't want to do that. Where is... Oh, it's hiding under my mirror thing. Okay, so this is the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus. It's a really good foundation for people with oily skin or like kind of like in between. It's actually good for like a lot of skin tones actually, but why they made it is for oily skinned women. But I think a lot of people like to use it anyways. My brush I'm going to be using is my Sigma F80 Kabuki brush. It's really good. I used to hate it. I used to actually hate both of them, but together I feel like the magic comes alive with these two together. So I kind of like dab it just because this foundation dries quickly on my skin. So I like to do, you know, one side first. And then when I apply it, I like to dab it. And then after I get it mostly all over, I like to go in and then do circular motion. You guys can tell that's a big difference. If you guys can see that. I don't think I'm going to do like a full coverage today, even though this is like really good coverage. I don't think I'm going to waste, just because it is at nighttime and I'm not really doing a whole lot. Except a few things I have to go do, but I'm not gonna, I have to like pretty much take it off in a few hours, so why, you know, use that product up when you can do it on a day that you're actually gonna go do something. So and sometimes, hold on. Sometimes the areas I need, I'll put a little bit more coverage on that area, like area that's like acne prone skin. Like there's a pimple on that side, I'll put a little bit more extra, but I'm not gonna do a lot with my face today with my foundation. You guys can see that, and it dries to like a matte. I mean, matte, like it doesn't dry like super matte, but it dries matte, like probably a semi matte. So if you don't like a super flat face, you know, this would be a really good one. Okay. So if I have time, I'm going to be actually putting highlight on under my eyebrows, but we'll see. Okay, so let's do that. Let's get my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. And it actually, this is like one of my go-tos, but it's not my go-to. It's actually a drugstore one. It's the Maybelline. It's my favorite one. I think this one takes out too much product. And since it is higher end, it does cost a little bit more. And so I like to use my Maybelline because it's a lot cheaper. And so that is why you see me using probably Maybelline a lot, because I love that product for the price. Sometimes I feel like it's better than the higher end. So what I'm going to be doing, I should have probably did my ring fingers or my middle finger, but I wasn't thinking. And what you want to do, since they're not as rough, that's why you want to use the ring finger. And I know I'm not supposed to slide, but I'm like having a crazy time. And this is like highlighting like this, not highlighting, concealing like this. This is like if you want to go out to like have going out to a party or dinner and you want a really extreme makeup look, like everybody knows that you're actually wearing makeup. This is probably the highlight. Why am I doing the highlight? Gosh. Yes, this is how I get ready. I talk to myself all the time and I have fun with myself. Okay, so I mean concealer, but usually I go like under the eye, like under there. And that's how I conceal it. Some people like go up on the forehead, on the nose, the just at a lot of places, and I don't like to do that just because I'm very oily, so yeah, that doesn't really work with my skin tone. So I'm going to be setting with my Airspun Loose Face Powder. It's really good. I heard this from Patrick Star, and actually it does have a smell to it, but usually you get over it. It has like more of an older lady look smell to it. Look, what a lady smell to it. And then you just want to pat. And I used to use my Revlon Color Stay. Sorry, I had a lot on my brush. I'm just like, what happened? You just want to pat it, swing type of song. And just once you get the powder on, you just kind of like swirl it just so you can get the excess off of it. But anyways, this is a really good product. I heard it from Patrick Star. And he said normally, I think what he said is they actually came out with a drag queens used to, you know, use it, and then people got a hold of it and just kind of went with it. So I'm actually gonna set my face now. And so the foundation powder that I usually go with, my go-to, is my MAC Studio Fix powder, but I'm not gonna be using that. And the shade I'm in with that is Neutral 5. I think it's just N5. But anyways, I'm gonna do my Estee Lauder one, and I actually used this yesterday again, and oh my gosh, like I'm in love with it. Like my makeup did not come off or shine through until like all day last night. It finally peeked through a little bit. I'm just like, dang. Like if you guys knew how oily my skin gets, where is it, within like 5 minutes of, you know, even if it's the best of products, it's like within 5-10 minutes it could probably shine through. Like that's how bad it is. But once you get your powder on, you want to pat. I'm not going to do like a heavy powder, but I'm going to do a little bit just to show you. You guys know me, I like my powders, I like my mattes, I like, you know, I like being matte. Okay, so that is good. And then I'm going to do my MAC blush in Mocha. It's a matte blush. Who'd have thought? So let's see if I can find it. And I don't know if I use this so much that it's just not even coming off anymore or what, but I don't know if you guys can see that, but I try to not like even go past my outer eye just because I don't like to drag my face down when I lift it, just because I do have a bigger face. And so for the fall time, I wanted a darker look with a blush with this look. And I forgot to contour, so I'm going to do that after I... That probably looks crazy. Oh, well. This look actually looks a lot darker on camera than what it is right now, so I'm actually going to change my settings and try to figure this out. But my contouring kit that I'm going to be using is my Kat Von D Locket, the Shade Light palette with my Wayne Goss. If you guys know me, I'm like my go-to. Every contour that I use this brush with it just because it's gonna probably die with me. Like, I love it that much. But anyways, I'm gonna start with my side. I'm just gonna bring it in. But I have a big forehead, so I want to like kind of make it look smaller, just kind of hide it. You guys can tell. Make it look more bronzy. And like, and then with my contour, I don't like to bring it all the way down like my blush. I like to bring it the closest. It's probably like my outer eye, like probably around here. I don't try to go past that, even though it kind of looks like it. But all the other brushes I've used, they look like my skin is so like so much just really bad, and like a lot of big pores, so like it always looks muddy, and like this brush never makes my face look muddy. And so yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna do that. Okay, so my next thing, I think that's pretty good. Anyways, my next one is my highlighters. But I contour because I like to have that look of sculpting and making my face look a little bit different from what I want it to look like. It just helps out. And then my highlighter brush. Why can't I find it? Anyways, there it is. So the highlights I'm going to be using, I'm actually going to be using two of them. This is a long get ready with me, isn't it? I'm going to actually use my Becca highlighter, the Jaclyn Hill Champagne Pop, and it's this color. I don't like to use it unless I really want to or have a look that I'm going for, just because it's limited edition and I don't want to waste it, just because when I run out of it, I'm going to be crying my eyes out if they don't have any more. My phone just went off, but if you guys can see that highlight right there. But anyways, I think the, which one, the other one looks, actually works a lot better for me. Is it Moonlight? Moonstone, I think? Yeah, Moonstone. That works a lot better for my skin tone. So that is why I like to use that one. And then this one I actually really love for my oily skin, the Hourglass Amplite Lighting Brush, and it's in Ethereal Glow. I can't even see that right now, but it's like more of a purplish look, pink. But this is actually really good for oily skin because it's more of a drier look. I don't know how to explain it, but it's more dry, I think, and it's more powdery. So like people that don't want to have a lot of extreme highlight, it won't look like you're oily, too oily. Like this would probably make you oily skin women look oily, but this, since it's more of a dry powder, like it doesn't make you look oily, it just makes you look like you have a natural glow, and I like that a lot. So anyways, I'm rambling again, and I know you guys hate that probably, but anyways, I'm actually gonna put some highlight up above under my eye. And I'm actually not gonna do my if you guys can tell. Yeah. Oh yeah. I'm gonna be highlighting like no other tonight. My husband's gonna be liking that. just kidding. So anyways, I'm actually gonna do my eyeliner again. Just to make it more black, just because with this look I wanna kind of go out. Make it more crazy. Okay, so I think I'm not gonna do the eyelashes. I was gonna actually do these ones, but I don't know if I'm feeling it right now, because if you guys want me to do a look that has eyelashes, let me know, because I don't know what you guys like on my channel, because you guys don't really communicate with me. So I think I'm gonna just do mascara right now, and I'm gonna do actually a drugstore one, because my Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara I love, but then I hate it at the same time, because it's not waterproof, but this is, and that's my go-to mascara. I hate mascaras where, like, because my eyes are so bad and so dried out that, and normally I curl them, but I'm going all over the place right now because there's so much stuff to get done for Christmas. I'm just like thinking so much, and there's so much going on with my family right now, and just like have so much stuff to do. So if I like skip something, comment below and tell me, and then I'll like do a video that you guys want, or you know, something that I think I'm gonna do like a holiday look with like high end and drugstores makeup. Yeah, there is some really good drugstore makeup. I'm trying not to open my eyes, I'm just like, if my phone is bugging you, I'm sorry. But okay, so a lot of times people could either go underneath and do like more of an even look, but I don't want to do that because my eyes are watering right now, so I feel like everything will just come off anyways. So, anyways, I don't want to, you know, put it underneath because I feel like everything's just going to come off. Anyways, and I don't want that. So this is my look. I'm gonna put lipstick on for you guys. And if I can find it. Okay, so what I'm gonna be doing is I can't really find a lip liner that matches my the balm matte huges, but I'm gonna use this one because I'm gonna go a little bit darker on my outer and then just kind of go I'm gonna actually rub it together, but I'm gonna see how I'm doing it. I want to like rub it in because like I want it dark, but I don't want it too like everybody knows it's like a lip liner. So I'm gonna put that on now. Oh man. Okay, my lipstick just dropped, so I'm gonna get it. So, I'm using my matte lipstick. This is moussey, but it dries matte. Okay, so that's gonna dry matte. But I'm gonna do my eyebrows quick. I'm gonna use my Anastasia brow wiz. And like, I do my eyebrows, but not like a lot, so I'm like, I'm not the best. So, but I do use this a lot. My phone's bugging me. You guys can tell. You always want to move upwards with it. See how my lips are matte? I love matte lipsticks, but I hate how they feel. Eyebrows take a long time if you guys don't ever do them. And I take a long time, and I probably still don't get them right, but I try because I hate having blonde eyebrows. Okay, so I know that they probably don't look the best, but hey, they're gonna work. Because I said so. So, this is what I came up with. So, and I'm gonna actually do a clear gel with my Lash Genius. Just this makes it, it's kind of like hairspray for hair. It's like just kind of locks them in place and just kind of combs them out. So it doesn't look like you have fake, super fake eyebrows. So I like it. Really good product. So yes, 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 yes. So this is my get ready with me. My hair is crazy. So this is my get ready with me. I hope you guys enjoyed it, but I think next time I'll do the full on like heavy duty look, but right now it's so like really late and I need to get stuff done and stuff like that in my eye. But yeah, I really like how this turned out actually. I hope this is actually paying off in, during camera, like just how the colors are together, but I actually really like it. Like, do you guys like it? Let me know. But anyways, I'm actually gonna get going. So this is my lovely get ready with me. I know it's probably crazy long, but please, please, please stay with me. And just, if you have made it this long, thank you, but anyways, thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Bye.